Kerr, and I am thrilled to welcome you to our 150th organ recital. We are so glad that you are here. I know that you are here because of the people that we have who are about to share the gift of music with you. But in case you tagged along with a friend and you aren't quite sure what you've gotten yourself into, you are about to experience the glory of the gift of music through some pretty ingenious hands. We're going to begin this evening. Jim Cook is here, and he's going to play for us. I've had the privilege of getting to work on the staff with all three of our organs this evening, which I think is rather remarkable, especially when you look at the time in which their tenure here at First Church has spanned. Jim Cook began as our organist. If I got my math done correctly, it was 25 years playing the organ, and then 31 years directing our choir, and sometimes those years overlapped where he was actually doing both. Do I have that right? So, pretty phenomenal. And then Mark Hayes came and was our organist for 24 years, and they worked together all of those years. And then now we have Patrick Evans, who is our choir director and minister of music, and then Richard Byrd, who is our organist here at First Church now. And all of these men are incredibly gifted with the gift of music and the excellence of which they are able to play and sing, but also in their gift in inviting others to join in making music and praising God through that. So I am so glad you are here. First Church has been around 150 years, and we have been celebrating it all year long. And so whether you knew that or not, you're here celebrating that with us as well. We are an open place for all to worship, grow, and serve. And so I hope you feel that wide and warm welcome this evening. Will you join me as we pray together? Loving Creator, here in the beauty of this space, we are in awe of your creativity. In your masterpiece of humanity and our diversity, we marvel at the uniqueness with which you have made every one of us. And God, we come together because tonight we look forward to being dazzled by music, which is your gift to us as well. And so may we breathe deep your grace and mercy. May we know that we are in a safe space, surrounded by people who love you and love one another. And may we relax as we are carried by the grace of the music that is played for us. Amen.
Thank you. a lot of fun. And maybe the main reason I'm wearing my lovely cape, which Judy made for when I played the recital here in the 1980s. So this is a well-worn garment for playing pieces like that. I do want to thank the church for asking us all to play. I think this is a wonderful occasion for us. I am particularly honored by the invitation to play with these other organists, younger organists, both of whom spent a little time in my studio in here, so it makes me particularly proud to be included on a program with them. The next two pieces I'm going to play, I'm sort of going to play as a set, just one right after the other, and they're both related to songs, but in a completely different way from each other. Edmund Lemaire was a British organist who came to the United States, spent a little bit of time in Chattanooga as the municipal organist there, had a great following. This was in the 1880s and the 90s and up into the 20th century when having a municipal organist wasn't a strange thing, and that was the way many people heard a lot of music. He transcribed all of the fabulous orchestral movements from operas that everybody thought was great. Once upon a time, I thought I could learn his transcription of Wagner's Ride of the Valkyries. But there was something about doing go-ho-to-ho that just sort of put me off. I couldn't really swing that while I was playing. So, along with those transcriptions, which are absolutely fabulous, he wrote a couple of very short, very popular pieces, including the Andantino and the Flat. After he left Chattanooga, and moved to California, he met a couple of gentlemen who really liked this piece. Now, this was written when this building was brand new, published in the 1892. It was still popular enough 20 years later that in 1925, these two guys who liked the piece worked with him and turned that beautiful organ piece into Moonlight and Roses, which is a popular song that was performed for decades. So from organ music to a song. A great, I think, tribute, probably the only piece of music most living people have ever heard. Then the next piece is just the opposite. Because after Sir Arthur Sullivan, I don't think he was Sir Arthur at that point, but after he set A Lost Chord, a poem by a late author, to music, it became one of the most famous songs ever written in the English language. It lasted so long that people were making fun of it in the 50s. You can find an old LP that was Andy Griffith's first stand-up comedy routine where he found the lost chord. He said the lady was sitting on the pyramid playing his harp and found the lost chord. That's another story altogether. Then, after the publication of the song and after it became so popular, I mean, people voted to hear it on the organ. So Mr. Barrett transcribed it as an organ solo. That's just the opposite of Moonlight and Roses. This time, a song became an organ piece. Makes much more sense if you've read the poem. If you don't know the song, enjoy it. And I have to say, I said I wanted to play this as a set, the two together, so no applause after the Andantino, but a heartfelt sigh.
Thank you.